Hello everyone, we've got another clean water systems instructional video for you today. Today we're going to discuss setting up your 7500M filter valve. This is just a general setup instruction video. Today we happen to have it on a neutralizer tank, but this would also apply for carbon, pro-ox, green sand if it was a sediment filter. So a couple things just for overall plumbing thing, you would definitely want to plumb in a bypass system for this valve. This valve does not come with an internal bypass system. So shutoff valve is good. In this particular case, we have a pre and post filter. But you want to have your bypass in here so you can isolate the valve off. You also definitely want a hose bib or some type of valve here where you can isolate the house and you can flush through the system. When you're setting up the initial plumbing for the valve, your inlet side is over here. There is an arrow right here. You can see inlet, outlet. Your drain is in the back of the unit. All three of these ports have a fitting that looks like this. It comes in your kit. And there is a blue rubber washer that comes with it. So the washer actually seats up against this side of the fitting when it goes into the valve. What you want to make sure of is on your pipe fittings that you go ahead and do all your taping, all your fittings that you're going to use on your pipe fittings prior to installing these into the valve. These only need to really be a little over hand tight going into the valve. If you over tighten them, you're going to end up cracking this and you're going to end up buying a new valve. So we don't want to see you doing that. On the back side, on the filter drain, you have your drain line flow control. That's going to look like this. Make sure your arrow is pointed the right direction going on the outlet. There'll be a bell reducer and a fitting here, so this will actually thread in to your fitting in the back. So you'll have your washer, your fitting, and then thread tape on this, and a little thread lock, and that guy there will thread into the valve. So you can preassemble that, thread it into the valve, run your drain line out to your drain here. Okay, you've gone ahead, your system's all plumbed up and your media is all in your tank. We're going to go ahead and plug this guy in. And as it's warming up, you'll see that 6761, that's the model number. Your unit may or may not go into this mode here. Right now you're actually in the service mode. You get your dynamic display shown here. And it's basically going to go back and forth between the days left for before regeneration and the time. And it's going to pivot back and forth between those two. So the first thing I wanted to do is show you the buttons. You have a button here. This is basically your menu button. This is your regeneration button. This is your up and down button for making adjustments on your numbers and or scrolling through when you're in the main menu. There's the little icon here, the little hourglass that shows you you're in service. Then there'll be a backwash, a rapid rinse, and I'll show you those. So the first thing we're going to do, okay, now this just went in. Now you'll see it going back and forth between the time and days. When the time is on, you'll see the little clock icon. And you have this little key here. That means the screen's locked. So the first thing we're going to do is go ahead and unlock the screen. We'll do that by pushing both of these up and down arrows at the same time. You see the key went out. Now we can go ahead and push this button that takes us into our menu. So this is our time. So you can use these to scroll back and forth. And when you get to one, if you want to change it, you'll go ahead and push this button. And you'll see it's blinking, so I can change that to, let's say, 11. And also when you're working these, you'll see this little wrench icon come on. That shows that you're doing something in the mode. Okay, so we've selected that one. We'll go to minutes. You can go up or down on the minutes. Select it again, and you're good to go there. So now we'll go on to the next parameter. This is the B01. This is an internal setting. You won't need to worry about this for the filter valves. This is used if you want to operate solenoid valves. We'll go into that in another video. Okay, this is step three. Now you can see this is your rapid wrench. It's flowing the arrows down. Again, if you want to change this, we want it set at 6 minutes, but if you want to change this, let's say it's a green sand filter, you go ahead and you can go up or down. These do not go back and forth digits, so it's kind of old school. You got to hold the button and run it all the way up. So let's just say we want to change this to 8 minutes. We'll go ahead and set it up to 8 minutes. And once you get your 8 minutes, you'll push this button again. And now step three is at 8 minutes. That's your rapid rinse. Okay, step two is 10 minutes. That's your backwashing time. Again, if you want to change it, you can change it or leave it there. Once you're done, push it. Okay, this currently is showing days between regeneration at 6. So we're going to set this at 3. We'll go ahead and push this. There's your 3 days. Press it again, so you'll now backwash every 3 days. The F00, this setting you want at 0, this means that it'll backwash once a day. You can set these up to backwash 2 or 3 times at that same time of day, but you don't want to do that. Just once is fine. Okay. The next one is 2. That's 2 o'clock in the morning. This is a military time valve, so if it was set at 1400 or 14, then it would go off at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So right now this would be 2 a.m., which is where we want it. Again, if you wanted to set it at 1 a.m., you could just push this, bring that guide down to where you want it, push it again, and you're good to go there. Okay, so then there's your time. You see the time icon again. So once you go through and you get everything set, you go ahead and hit this button, the second one over, just once. And you'll see the dynamic display come back up. You'll see the eyeglass going on there. And the screen should go back and forth between days left. And you'll notice we reprogrammed this for 3, but it's now counting down from the 24 hours to 2 days to regeneration. And you can see that it's going back and forth between the time and the days generation. Next thing I wanted to cover was actually going ahead and using the programming to perform a regeneration button. Okay, so you see your lock is here, so we'll have to go ahead and unlock the screen holding both of these at the same time. The clock little key goes off. Go ahead, you can push this button now, and this will actually go through it, start your regeneration cycles. Okay, so you can now see we're in the backwash cycle. Our timer is counting down from the 10 minutes. If you want to go ahead and advance to the rapid rinse, you would just press it again. You can now see the rapid rinse. The arrow is pointing down and it's counting down from the 8 minutes. Remember, we set this for a green sand, it would be 6 minutes for your other filters. And now we've cycled back around. So get the dynamic display going, we're back into the service mode. So now that we've got our valve hooked up and we have programmed our valve, we want to go ahead and bring it on for service. The first thing that's very important to do is run these systems through several backwash regeneration cycles prior to using them and bring them online to the house. So you notice we have both our inlet and outlet valves closed now here. This is closed, so what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead, unlock this. Go ahead and go into our first regeneration mode, which is our backwash. So now that our system is in the backwash mode, we're going to go ahead and plug the unit, because we want to keep this in backwash mode. So we're going to slowly, very slowly, this is a very important step, folks. You don't want to shove, remember, this water is going down through your D-tube, up through your media. You don't want to take all those fines from the new media and shove up into your head. It'll clog your head up. So what we want to do is slowly bring this open. It may take you up to 10 minutes to open this. I want you to just go real slow, a little bit at a time. You know, wait a minute, a little more. Hopefully you've got a clear hose hooked up here. You're just going to watch this. Kind of keep increasing it over a period of 10-15 minutes, then you're fully open. All right, then what you can do is go ahead, plug the unit back in. Remember, very important not to open this too fast. Okay, you're going to come back up, and you can see it'll continue counting down. So go ahead and let this flow, count down, let it run through its backwash cycle. It'll go into the forward cycle. I'll just do it manually into your rapid rinse cycle. You want to do this back and forth 2, 3, 4 times, even sometimes, depending on what media and what size your system is, until during your rinse cycle you see the media here coming out clean. Once you see this clear up, then you can go ahead at that point and open your outlet valve on your system. And then before you bring in your water pressure up into your house, you want to go ahead, open this, your hose bib here. This is a good place to go ahead and sample it if you want to take some samples before you bring your system online. Anyway, that covers our 7500M setup. Oh, one other thing I did want to show you that's neat about this valve. This valve can also be manually operated if you were to lose power. There's an arrow on here. You want to make sure you turn this the correct way. So if there's no power, you can just turn this and you'll watch your little orange indicator come across to backwash, in service, or rapid rinse. Also, it's neat, if you don't want to use the programming method, you can actually just click it a couple of places and it'll go automatically. And you can see the little indicator spinning around here, and right now we're in service mode. So the manual feature on this valve is kind of neat. If you needed to use it manually, you can. Just wanted to show you guys that. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks.